I think we can all agree that 3D printers are incredibly cool. I have owned my printers for several years now, but I still cannot help but stare every time a new model is created layer by layer. It's just so nice to look at all the components working in harmony to create a perfect print. Stepper motors, motherboard, pulleys, fans, hotend and extruder have to work just right to make it happen. But even when they do, they still have one very annoying flaw. They can be really, really noisy. And if you happen to sleep or work in the same room as your printers, the noise is not only irritating, but can also have negative effects on your sleep and ability to focus. Personally, I have had enough of that noise, so in this video we are going to make it disappear. Okay, so first, if you want to eliminate the noise, we need to find its main sources. And it's actually not that hard. It's mostly load fans and stepper motors with old drivers. Another source might be in bearings. From my experience, linear bearings on roads can be quite loud. And if not correctly aligned, they can even make this terrible grinding noise. I used to have this problem on my first number-tired 3D printer, but when I swapped the bearings for the plastic ones, they became a lot quieter. Linear rails are obviously better for smooth and precise motion, but they create some noise as well. The quietest option is actually the cheapest one. Simple V-slot wheels are almost silent when operating, and luckily that's the motion system that is installed on both of my printers. There of course could be more minor noises coming from the printers that we will try to identify at the end, but now let's get started with the biggest problem, fans. Many 3D printers come with cheap and noisy fans that in long term can be unbearable to our ears. In my printers, most of the sound seems to come from the powerful toolhead blower fans and also from active cooled power supplies. The fans are essential for reliable 3D printer operation, so we can't just throw them out. What we can do is replace them with something quieter. Now, I know that currently Noctua fans are probably the best choice for quiet cooling, but I don't want this project to cost a fortune. And those fans certainly aren't cheap. So instead I ordered fans from my local brand that should be quiet enough at a reasonable price. You can basically buy any fans you want, just make sure that they are the same size as the one in your printer. Once my fans arrived, I opened my power supply, removed the top cover and compared their noise level. The new fans are indeed a lot quieter. So now we just need to replace the old one. After all, they are both 12 volts, so it should work just fine. However, it's kinda weird that we have a 12 volt fan in a 24 volts power supply. So to make sure, I measured the voltage on the fan pins and it was actually 24 volts. So that poor fan was working all the time at twice his nominal voltage. That and the poor quality of the fan explains all the noise it was making. Okay, but now we have a problem. We have a bunch of 12 volt fans and nowhere to power them from. The easiest way to deal with it would be to simply buy a back converter. However, recently I started learning how to design my own PCBs, and with the help of today's sponsor, PCBWay, I can actually make them real. So I designed my first simple voltage regulator board. Once I had my project ready, I logged onto the PCBWay site, chose the right board parameters, uploaded the design file, and finally ordered my PCBs. After just a few days, I received my package, and I gotta admit, those PCBs look very nice. Next, it was just a matter of soldering some components and later testing if the board works correctly. Now, if we input 24 volts, we get exactly 12 volts at the output. So it works alright. Now, if you also want to make your own boards like me, just head out to the PCBWay website, the link will be in the description. So thank you PCBWay for sponsoring this video, And now back to our fans. Right, so now we screw the new fan right back to the power supply, lead the fan wires outside and assemble the whole thing back. Now let's leave my Ender free for a moment and let's take a look at my bigger printer, Anycubic Chiron. Now this thing is a lot louder and also quite a lot bigger, so I had to place it upside down. Now we basically have to perform the same procedure, open the power supply and remove the old fan. This one was actually 24 volts, but it was still really loud, so we have to replace it as well. Next we mount the new fan, lead the fan wires out and assemble the power supply back. That wasn't so hard, but we got a lot more fans to go. In this printer there is also one loud fan cooling stepper drivers, so I removed it as well and replaced with the new one. Next I mounted the voltage regulator PCB inside the printer case and connected its input to power and output to fans. Later I also added new wires coming out for the hot end fans. Now the thing that catches my eye are those red stepper drivers. Those are the cheapest possible A4988 step sticks that cause the motors to create terrible high frequency noise. Luckily, previously I ordered some new TMC2209 drivers which offer some sweet functions like sensorless homing or stealth jump. That last one is especially useful as it makes the motors almost silent. However, before buying, make sure that your motherboard can make a good use out of them. Those drivers can work in two modes, standalone or UART. If your motherboard like mine SKR 1.3 in Ender 3 can use them in UART, then you can enjoy all the special features. But if not, like in my Anycubic, then you can only use them in standalone mode. They will still be quiet, but that's just it. And in that case, it might be better to get a bit cheaper TMC2208. Anyway, before removing the old drivers, it's a good idea to check and write down their voltages, so it will be easier to correctly configure the new ones. The higher the voltage, the more current the driver can supply to the motor. However, this will also make both driver and motor run hotter, so the best idea is to find a good balance. When I installed the new drivers, I made sure to set them at the same voltage level as the old ones. Next, I placed heatsinks on all 5 of them. But it's still not the end. In my case, I also had to swap wires in each connector in order for them to work correctly. Each motherboard model is different, so it's best to read documentation or watch a tutorial before replacing your own drivers. Okay, so now we are finished with the Anycubic electronics. Let's get back to Ender 3. Here replacing drivers was a lot easier. It was just a matter of swapping them and making some minor changes in software. I also added the voltage regulator board and connected all the fans. In, well, a chaotic way. But basically, if you want to control a 12-volt fan with 24-volt motherboard, you need to connect fan positive to voltage regulator and fan negative to original motherboard fan pin, like on this diagram. In this printer, I set up hot end, power supply and case fans to start spinning when the nozzle reaches 50 degrees. And the print cooling fan is speed controlled by PWM. Speaking about hot end fans, we need to replace them as well. I prepared all the wires in both printers before to use 12 volts, so now it's just a matter of designing new fan ducts. So in Fusion 360 I created two different designs for each of my printers. Both of them use E3D V6 hotend mounted on a quick tool shape system designed by Proper Printing. For Ender 3 I decided to use 40mm fan for hotend cooling and 50mm fan for blowing cold air under the nozzle. In Anycubic, I use a direct drive system with volcano heat block, so I had to modify my previous project a bit, And in this case, I decided to give it a bigger 60mm print cooling fan. Once I had all the 3D files ready, I printed them from PTG for better heat resistance. Later, I simply screwed all the fans to the fan ducts and finally attached them to the printers. Okay, so now when we replaced all the old drivers and loud fans, it's time for a noise test. So, from what we can hear, it's definitely a lot better. We got rid of all the motor noise and the annoying fans hum. But there are still some weird sounds coming out of the printers. Mainly the Anycubic makes a loud creaking sound while moving the bed. So, after the inspection, I decided to remove the Y-axis motor dampener, as the noise seemed to be coming from that direction. Ultimately, it turned out to not be the reason. The reason was a misaligned belt that was rubbing against the motor pulley. So, after the correction, the noise went away. Last modification I decided to make was to add 3D printed PTG vibration dampening feet to both of the printers. They are the simplest method to reduce vibrations coming from the printer to solid surfaces like table, and therefore they make the whole machine a lot quieter. However, those 3D printed feet are actually not the best method to silence the printers. CNC Kitchen made a great video about this topic, but if you don't have a big concrete slab laying around, those feet will get the job done as well. So, I placed all the feet under my printers and then made the noise test again. And now, we finally achieved real silence. There are of course still few minor things that could be improved, like extruder or filament spool sounds, but honestly for me it's quiet enough already. After all those upgrades, I actually find myself picking at the printers more often, cause they are so quiet I just think they stopped printing. And the best thing is, those modifications were not even expensive. For one printer it cost me about $10 for fans, and another $10 for TMC drivers. So $20 in total for a peace of mind. I think it's really worth it. And that's all for now. Thank you guys for watching. Thanks again PCBWay for sponsoring this video. And see you all soon. Bye!